मुश्किल नहीं है, सिर्फ ये है बंगाल सरकार टांग नहीं अड़ाना चाहे। ऑटोनोमस का अप्रोप्रिएट जो मीनिंग है उसको वो लोग का समझना चाहे, बस इतना, सक्सेस हो जाए।
In 1986, when the agitation for a separate state of Gorkhaland was launched by the GNLF, few political observers could predict the movement would sustain for so long, or that in the subsequent 2 years, it would create so much havoc in the Darjeeling Hill areas. Subhas Ghising and his followers claimed that they were ostensibly in search of an identity for the Indian Gorkha. But most analysts were convinced that beneath this yearning for a sense of identity was actually resentment at the economic neglect of the Darjeeling Hills and a desire to manage their own affairs. Time and again, the center ruled out division of West Bengal, and both the state government and GNLF refused to negotiate. The agitation began to take a militant turn. The wrath of the activists was unleashed in the state government properties, which became convenient targets for the arsonists. Bloody clashes between the paramilitary forces and the militants became a regular phenomenon. The accumulation of arms by the activists and the alleged presence of training camps alarmed the authorities. There was realization that an immediate solution to the Darjeeling problem was imperative. And the prolonged buns called by the GNLF leadership not only paralyzed life in the hill areas, but created immense difficulties for the common man. The first sign of a breakthrough and a possible settlement was evident in January 1988. At a tripartite meeting in Delhi, the proposal for a hill council was mooted. But before the modalities could be worked out, fresh differences cropped up and the meeting ended in a stalemate. However, all three parties were determined to come to a settlement, and on 22nd August 1988, a historic accord was signed in Calcutta between the GNLF, the West Bengal government, and the central government. One of the main features of the accord was the creation of the Darjeeling Gorkha Hill Council. The council was to have 42 members, 28 elected and 14 nominated. Among the nominated members would include the Member of Parliament from Darjeeling District, the three MLAs from the Darjeeling, Kalimpong and Kursiong subdivision, and the municipal chairman. The jurisdiction and the role of the council was defined, and the first step towards bringing normalcy to the Darjeeling Hills was thus taken.
I am very, very happy that at last we could come to an agreement, and everything has been worked out. Now we are waiting for the Hill Council to be constituted after the elections are over, and we are very serious about implementing it. Because I said earlier that it is not only a problem of West Bengal, it is a problem of the whole of India, as I look at it. Therefore, with all earnestness, we have to see that it is implemented.
But in order for the accord to be successfully implemented, it was imperative that the cult of violence, which had become a dangerous and regular occurrence, was to be eradicated. In an extraordinary gesture of cooperation, the GNLF and CPM cadres agreed to lay down their arms, and on 2nd October 1988, began the biggest armed surrender in the Darjeeling Hills.
आज 2 तारीख अक्टूबर गांधी जयंती के उपलक्ष्य में हम लोग दार्जिलिंग गोरखा हिल काउंसिल के संपूर्ण इलाका से जितना भी आर्म्स एंड एमुनिशन था जनता ने बनाया था वो आज से सरेंडर हो रहा है और 4 तारीख में खरसांग का सरेंडर होगा उसके बाद में 8 तारीख कालिम्पोंग होगा 10 तारीख दार्जिलिंग होगा और 12 तारीख 13 14 तारीख के अंदर सारा हथियार जितना भी है पहाड़ में सब सरेंडर हो जाएगा उसके बाद में दार्जिलिंग पहाड़ में पूरा कंप्लीट पीस आ जाएगा
Although the armed surrender was received with great enthusiasm, some skeptics called it a farce, claiming that only a fraction of the total arms in possession of the militants had actually been brought out. But the district administrators disagreed and said that the surrender was in fact a unique event and successfully carried out.
Armed surrender was, in my opinion, a success. You know, the very fact that the persons who were wielding the arms and, you know, they were using those camouflage army uniforms and things like that, all these persons came from all the remote areas to Darjeeling. They carried their own weapon, whether it was a country-made one or whether it was a snatched weapon or any other weapon or bombs. Or the fuses, all kinds. You know. That they came in a ceremony to surrender the arms to Darjeeling, and they went back to the bastis. And Darjeeling is not a very big place. You know, it's about 6 lakh odd population in the hill areas now. That would have a psychological impact on the people that there is no more need to use the arms, and that is the biggest achievement now. Now, I can't really make a guess how much percentage has been surrendered. But the fact remains that the arms will not be freely used, and that's what we have seen in the last 2 months, that they have not been freely used.
आज तक कभी नहीं हुआ है ऐसा, भारत में भी नहीं हुआ है, किसी कंट्री में भी नहीं हुआ है, फर्स्ट क्लास हो गया, सक्सेस हुआ है, जो मैंने आगे बोला था, ज्यादा से ज्यादा मात्रा में क्या हुआ है, ये पाइप का जो है ना, जीआई पाइप का हथियार बनाया बोल दिया था, वो सब सरेंडर कर दिया, ओरिजिनल था सरेंडर कर दिया, लेकिन कम्युनिस्ट ने कितना सरेंडर किया, लेकिन वो मालूम हो गया.
Yes, they had 4 times, we had about 1,000 was surrendered. That they knew, our people also knew, where we could not send the police, unfortunately, because we didn't have enough policemen to guard the entire hill area, and the terrain being what it is, well, they also must have collected arms, as the GNLF had collected arms. Both were illegal.
The second and more important aspect of the implementation of the accord was the holding of the elections for the Hill Council. After the delimitation and formalities had been worked out, the election date was announced and the election process took over. But fear of violence and recurrence of incidents of arson prompted the authorities to take strict measures in order to ensure that both the campaign and the polling went off peacefully. But prior to the election was a task of rehabilitation of all those villagers who had fled their homes during the 2 years of violent agitation.
The elections, we had about 28 elected constituencies which the delimitation order we had made on the basis of 12 to 14,000 voters in one compact area. That was finalized on the 15th of November. And then the nominations started. The withdrawal of candidates was last date was 28th of November. And on the 13th, we had the poll. We used about 2,100 polling personnel, and in all about 70 companies of state police and paramilitary forces. We had made adequate arrangements in all the polling stations so that people could vote and reduce any chances of a clash on the day of the poll.
But there have been a few stray incidents, and we have looked into those cases. We have ensured that the violence should be kept at its minimum, and I don't think that there have been very many cases of violence as we apprehended earlier, that after the arms surrender, before the polls would begin, you know, that there would be violence. But there have been a few incidents, but we have tackled all these incidents properly, and we haven't spared people who are involved in incidents of violence.
Subhas Gising was declared elected unopposed from one of the two constituencies he filed nomination papers from. And although the GNLF contested all 28 seats, opponents claimed that the GNLF were intolerant of any opposition. And some intra-party clashes were the main feature of the violence during the poll campaign. There were fresh political tremors, however, when news reports stated that Gising had revived the Gorkhaland statehood demand.
During this election, suddenly the newspapers came out with screaming headlines that Mr. Gising was going to have decided to demand Gorkhaland once again, a separate state of Gorkhaland. I must confess, I was surprised, I was distressed, I was taken aback. And I had occasion to speak to Mr. Gising thereafter, and he assured me that whatever he had said was because he had been gravely provoked by the campaign, the poll campaign of the West Bengal government and some of the Congress I members, who were trying to steal his thunder by turning around and saying that Mr. Gising had promised you this, but what has he got? He has given you only an autonomous unit which the West Bengal government and the CPM claimed was being offered to them in any case by them. So they were trying to steal his thunder, pull the carpet from under his feet.
In democracy, in democratic process, every party, every group, every individual has every right to contest, to participate. Therefore, I think there is no point in saying that Congress, CPM or other party, All India Party, has nothing to do with the election.
A political party must contest all categories or stages of elections, because a party has got an ideology and ethos, principles, and programs. In order to implement these things, they must capture the power. And through that mandate only, we can be able to implement our policy.
Before signing agreement, kya kya tha bola tha? Agreement signing sa hai ki ki interim council hone sa chahiye at least for 6 months. Uske baad mein election karana chahiye. Tab to democratic process mein hoga. Kyunki idhar Darjeeling mein pahad mein to ek pichlana hai. Wo nahi mana. उसके बाद में मैंने दिल्ली में तो आप लोग नहीं मानते हैं तो इस बार से आप लोग को डिस्टर्ब नहीं करना होगा दोनों पार्टी से आपका जो प्रेस्टीज है फॉर्मेलिटी है तो थोड़ा खड़ा करिए उम्मीदवार लेकिन ये लोग ने क्या किया कलकत्ता से पैसा भेजना शुरू किया अजीब लाख लाख रुपया अजीब ये MLA इलेक्शन जैसा हो गया असेंबली इलेक्शन जैसा अजीब ये दार्जिलिंग गोरखा हिल काउंसिल इंस्टीट्यूट जैसा बना दिया ये ऑटोनोमस काउंसिल में ये इंटरफेयर बाहर से इंटरफेयर नहीं कर सकता है स्टेट वुड जैसा इलेक्शन हो गया असेंबली इलेक्शन उसमें कर सकता है
गोरखा हिल काउंसिल मात्र भएको छ तर किन आज फेरि GNLF ले भोट चुनाव लड्यो भन्ने शायद तपाईहरुको मनमा अवश्य एउटा प्रश्न चिन्ह खडा हुन्छ यही प्रश्न चिन्हलाई CPM को तत्वहरुले तर पहिलाको मञ्चबाट हामीले
The campaign was lively though low key and it was only in a few seats that the GNLF actually faced any major test of strength. The turnout for the Darjeeling Gorkha Hill Council elections was impressive. Almost 80% of the voters exercised their right, and the average citizen was proud to participate in what to him was an important decision-making process.
ये चुनाव करने का फायदा ये होता है कि हम अपना प्रतिनिधि अपना गोरखा हिल काउंसिल का प्रतिनिधि चुनेंगे और उसको अपना आगे भेजेंगे वो जाके अपना यहाँ के जनता के मांग करेंगे जो हमारे यहाँ असुविधाएं हैं जैसा कि पानी नहीं है बत्ती नहीं है लोगों का रोजीकारी नहीं है स्कूल कॉलेज नहीं है इत्यादि
यो चुनाव दार्जिलिंग गोरखा पार्वत्य परिषद गठन को लागि हो जसले दार्जिलिंग को गोरखाहरुलाई यहाँ को विकास को निम्ति यो काउन्सिलले काम गर्छ हाम्रो यही फाइदा हो
डिस्पाइट द फियर अफ वायलेंस बाय एन्ड लार्ज द पोलिङ वाज कन्डक्टेड विदाउट एनी मेजर ब्रीच अफ पीस Although in some polling booths of Kalimpong, certain opposition members claimed the GNLF had resorted to rigging and intimidation.
Booth ke andar ye le ja nahi sakta aur koi rule mein nahi hai. To un logon ne ye usko rule ko bhi supersede karke zabardasti wahan andar ghus kar iske andar ja kar ye dikhakar wahan ka jo hai voteron ko isme sign thokna karke isme sign marna isme stamp marna karke dikhakar ye sab jo hai karta tha jo ki iske hamare rule ke virudh tha kaam karta
ye to mamooli hai
ऐसे बहुत हर बूथ में ऐसे मिला था इससे भी रैगिंग हुआ और कईयों तरफ से रैगिंग हुआ है जिससे कि हमें इसीलिए हमें इस साल मतलब ये इलेक्शन में हमारा कुछ ऐसा नहीं
एज फार एज इलेक्शन इज कंसर्न वी आर गोइंग बाय द रूल्स एंड आई हैव टू से दैट इफ देर इज एनी कंप्लेंट ऑन द इलेक्शन देर इज एन इलेक्शन अथॉरिटी देर इज ए जुडिशियल प्रोसीजियर एंड आई इम्प्रेस्ड अपॉन ऑल दैट एट दिस पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम देर इज नो पॉइंट इन डिलेइंग द इलेक्शन और doing anything else because the rules don't permit.
The allegations of minor rigging notwithstanding, the GNLF swept the polls and confirmed Subhas Ghising's hold over the Darjeeling Hills. His party captured power, winning 26 out of the 28 seats with large majorities, and accused the district administration of not conducting a fair election in the 2 seats they lost to the CPM, where they had in fact asked for a postponement of elections.
Shri Ratan Kumar Rai, 53. Tirpan, Sri K.B. Rai, 10,698, 10,698, Sri Sukhan Subba, 26, 26, number of rejected votes, 251.
Although the celebrations of the GNLF victory were subdued by Darjeeling Hill standards, many citizens were glad to hear that song and dance had once again made a comeback and there was spontaneous and popular rejoicing over the victory.
certainly he has been able to arouse the large number of Nepalese there. There is no doubt about it. Apart from the violence and all that, they were also roused into activity. And we knew that this would be the result. In fact, as far as we are concerned, we expected another seat. Instead of three, now we have got two. Of course, during the elections, about 80% people voted. Underground, there was some sort of threat or something. Some reports were there, but I have no reports of rigging or anything like that.
Jitna bhi aage tha, jo tasteless tha, jitna bhi maza nahi tha, jaise election mein bhi maza nahi tha. Is baar ka election kaisa hua? Apna election jaisa ho gaya. Sense of belonging tha isme, is election mein. Aage nahi tha. Imposition jaisa tha election. Zabardasti bol dalna hai, koi maza nahi tha. ऐसा था 40 वर्ष अभी इस बार क्या हुआ इलेक्शन अपना इलेक्शन जैसा हो गया ये पहाड़ का इलेक्शन अपना इलेक्शन जनता सब खुश हो गया इस बार के इलेक्शन में कहां-कहां से आया दार्जिलिंग का आदमी जैसे भूटान में था सर्विस करने के लिए गया था नेपाल में गया था सिक्किम नागालैंड आसाम सब आ गया
सिलेक्शन ऑफ द दार्जिलिंग गोरखा हिल काउंसिल मेंबर्स हैज नाउ सेट द स्टेज फॉर न्यू पॉलिटिकल डेवलपमेंट्स इन द दार्जिलिंग हिल्स देयर इज अ ग्रेट डील ऑफ एक्सपेक्टेशन अमंग द पीपल एंड द कंसेंसस इज दैट द फर्स्ट मेजर हर्डल in redressing the grievances and aspirations of the hill people has been successfully crossed.
Main thing now is development, because they have enough powers. Under them will work will function the municipalities. Three of them are there, as well as the panchayats now. Of course, later on we'll have to have the panchayats elections again, because in the earlier period, because there was violence, we could not hold the panchayat elections. But whatever is elected, they will all be supervised and guided by the hill council. So entire development works, economic programs and so on and so forth, will be done through this hill council. Of course, they also have to interact with our planning board. So almost all departments will be with them, not only tourism, but almost all departments.
Much will depend upon the attitude both of the West Bengal government and of Mr. Ghesing and his party men. I do earnestly hope that the West Bengal government will carry out the accord both in its letter and spirit. It must go ahead and extend every possible cooperation to Mr. Ghesing in making it a success. And as you know, it's one thing to give certain powers on paper and quite another to enable the person who's got these powers to really exercise them. So as I said, much will depend upon the West Bengal government.
More than the actual benefit which may accrue immediately, it is the sense of participation of the people in the process of development. That will surely be better, because the felt needs of the hill people, hill areas are a separate category for development in our planning process. These things started in 1974. We have hill areas in Darjeeling, then in Gadwal in UP, Nilgiris in Tamil Nadu. The participation of people surely will make development a more target-oriented one. And achievement of targets will surely help the people. It all depends on the modalities of the council functioning, how they are worked out, how is the plan made, the availability of funds. But I hope it will be surely better.
However, the suspicion and hostilities aroused during the last 2 years is not easily reduced. And political observers are anxious to see that after the swearing in of the council, the body is allowed to function independently without constant interference from the state government.
कुछ मुश्किल नहीं है सिर्फ ये है बंगाल सरकार टांग नहीं अड़ाना चाहे ऑटोनोमस का अप्रोप्रिएट जो मीनिंग है उसको वो लोग का समझना चाहे बस इतना सक्सेस हो जाए
इन फैक्ट द इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ द अकॉर्ड वॉज मेड इजियर बिकॉज ऑफ सम गुड कोऑपरेशन दैट वी गॉट फ्रॉम द जीएनएलएफ लीडरशिप एंड देर वॉज नॉट मच कम्युनिकेशन गैप बिटवीन द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड द जीएनएलएफ लीडरशिप ऑन दिस मैटर Like the other parties also, the CPIM, they also cooperated in all the efforts that we made, the armed surrender, the rehabilitation process.
I am very positive and optimistic that in the future there may not be many misunderstandings at all. And I hope that it will be a functional one. And if there are misunderstandings on some issues, they can always be thrashed out. The important thing is that there has to be a proper communication between the council and the state government. And I have no reasons to fear that it will not be there.
There is a fear that you may not, at least some people in your party, may not allow a smooth functioning of the Hill Council. Would you give a categorical assurance?
No, no, that is absurd, you see, because as I have been saying, which some people don't like my saying so, that we have been talking about autonomy for the hill areas of Darjeeling district, and that has come. So we should be happy. We should not be unhappy because we are not in the majority. We wanted an elected council. It has come under in a situation where, of course, there was agitation, violence, and all that. But again, that is a thing of the past. But now that the council has been elected, it should function. That is how it will set an example to the whole of India.
The election results has marginalized nearly all political parties. But dissidents within the GNLF, though subdued for the moment, can become a major factor in the future. It is the Kalimpong subdivision which poses the greatest threat to Subhas Gyasing. It is in this area where a former Gyasing loyalist, Chhatre Subba, challenged the so-called militant leader from Kalimpong, C.K. Pradhan, for political supremacy. The battle between these two factions and the intra-party clashes have caused serious concern to the administrators. Though Gyasing himself finds Subba inconsequential and accuses him of being a government plant.
उसके पास कोई बुद्धि नहीं है, वो पॉलिटिक्स नहीं जानता है, वो और का ब्रेन पर चलता है, कोलकाता का ब्रेन पर चलता है, वो अपना उसका नहीं है, खाली है ये, अपर स्टेट उसका जो है खाली है, इसलिए वैसा खाली वाला आदमी अपना पार्टी में रखना भी तो अच्छा है, ही नहीं, इसीलिए जो अलग हो गया अच्छा ही हो गया
मैं पहले सुभाष गिसिंग के साथ जरूर थे जब सुभाष गिसिंग गोरखालैंड के साथ थे हम वास्तव में गोरखालैंड के साथ थे न कि सुभाष गिसिंग के साथ थे अभी उसने गोरखालैंड का मूवमेंट जब ड्रॉप कर दिया छोड़ दिया तो हमने भी उनको छोड़ दिया जब वो गोरखालैंड को फिर से शुरू करेगा हम उसके साथ होने के लिए हमेशा तैयार है
इट वाज एक्स्ट्राऑर्डिनरी दैट मिस्टर छात्रे सुबा हु वाज सपोज्ड टू बी रेजिंग द डिमांड फॉर गोरखालैंड वाज सीम्ड टू बी सो फ्रेंडली टू दोज who were chasing and hounding the GNLF leaders. That is why, as I said, I'm not surprised that he's been called a Sarkari candidate. I personally think that Mr. Chhatre Subba and his very small group of friends or henchmen or whatever you'd call them, and this small group, as the polls have shown, has been found out, left high and dry, that this group had really been put up, as it happens on occasions, by those in authority only as a counterpoise in the game of political chess which was going on in the Darjeeling Hill areas.
The economy of the Darjeeling Hills, which has received a battering and is in shambles, will benefit most from the Hill Council formation. The month of October 1988 saw the first rush of tourists to this hill station. The tea industry, which has suffered huge losses the last 2 years, is now looking forward to recouping some of it once normalcy returns to the area.
As long as the government takes the proposals set by the Hill Council seriously, I think there will be peace and people will come naturally because they don't want to be disturbed. They're spending so much money, they're coming on a holiday and they don't want to be, you know, disturbed by all these stray incidents. And as long as there's peace, definitely the tourists will come.
Now that there is a political settlement and that the Hill Council will come in it'll be formed and it will begin to function. I'm sure generally everything in Darjeeling will improve and certainly will not go back to what we've been facing in the last 3 years. I firmly believe that both the centre and the state governments will give full backing to the council